I have determined that it is time to officially recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel.
Rage and worry around the world after Donald Trump's Jerusalem decision. Senior managers of local financial advisory company taken into custody. And another day of legal antics at Hong Kong's legislative chamber. Good evening and welcome. U.S. President Donald Trump has shattered decades of U.S. neutrality on Jerusalem, declaring the divided holy city as Israel's capital. Trump says a new approach is needed, but the move has sparked worry and concern around the world. Alan Bookney reports.
Defying dire worldwide warnings, Trump said the United States would move its embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem.
This is a long overdue step to advance the peace process and to work towards a lasting agreement. Israel is a sovereign nation with the right, like every other sovereign nation, to determine its own capital.
Trump brushed aside appeals for caution from around the world.
We cannot solve our problems by making the same failed assumptions and repeating the same failed strategies of the past. All challenges demand new approaches. My announcement today marks the beginning of a new approach to conflict between Israel and the Palestinians.
In Jerusalem, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu hailed the announcement as historic.
The president's decision is an important step towards peace, for there is no peace that doesn't include Jerusalem as the capital of the state of Israel.
U.S. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson, who was reportedly against Trump's decision, said they are preparing for a backlash.
We're confident that we'll protect everyone, provide security for everyone, and all of our missions and embassies in the region, and we've properly issued warnings to others as well.
This analyst doubts recognizing Jerusalem as Israel's capital can have a positive impact on the peace process and says he doesn't think it was designed to.
However, the president may have dressed it up as such in his speech. This was about domestic politics. I think that much is clear. This was a nod to a campaign promise, to a particular part of his conservative base.
The Palestinians seek East Jerusalem, captured by Israel in 1967, for their capital. By recognizing Israel's claim, they see Trump as siding with the Israelis on the most sensitive issue in the conflict. Alan Bookney, TVB News.
Well, Trump's move to recognize Jerusalem as Israel's capital has triggered a worldwide chorus of criticism. In the Palestinian territories, demonstrators clashed with security forces. Some protesters say Palestinians should withdraw from all peace negotiations with the Israelis. Leaders are calling the decision irresponsible and unjustified and are warning it could lead to disastrous consequences. The leader of Palestinian Islamic militant group Hamas said the decision would be igniting the spark of rage against the occupation. Earlier, Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas said Trump's move was tantamount to the United States abdicating its role as a peace mediator. A resolution to impeach U.S. President Donald Trump has been overwhelmingly defeated in the House of Representatives. Congressman Al Green, a Democrat from Texas, put forward the impeachment resolution, citing incidents that showed bigotry and racism. But it was ruled out by a vote of 364-58, meaning 126 Democrats sided with the Republicans. House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi said now is not the time. Green said impeachment is a process and that this was a step in that process. Here at home, the city's anti-graft agency is confirming tonight that it has arrested three senior executives of Convoy Financial Services. Sources say one of them is the vice chairman and executive director, Rosetta Fong, while the other is executive director, Christy Chan. At least a dozen members of Convoy senior management were taken into the IAC headquarters in North Point to assist with the investigation. They were seen leaving the premises earlier tonight. The investigation centers on allegations that someone used the company to receive benefits amounting to around $47 million. Company chairman Quincy Wong, who's currently in Taiwan, and executive director Cho Kwe Chi are apparently also persons of interest. Shares of Convoy were suspended from trading on the Hong Kong Stock Exchange this morning. Two people from an interior design and decor company have been arrested on suspicion of violating the trade descriptions ordinance. Officers made the arrests this morning at the company's office in Tsim Sha Tsui following a complaint the company lied about the progress of a project. The company also allegedly breached its contract by carrying out additional work without prior notification. The extra work carried a price tag of $1.3 million. Customs officers have arrested a 31-year-old man who allegedly tried to smuggle 35 kilograms of suspected gold into Hong Kong. Authorities made the seizure during a routine inspection of an incoming car at the Shenzhen Bay control point yesterday. 35 pieces of suspected gold was discovered when officers popped open the trunk. The haul is worth an estimated $11 million. The High Court has adjourned the sentencing of 16 Occupy activists to a later date. Sharon Tang was at the courthouse.
Joined by the supporters, the 16 defendants arrived at the High Court this afternoon to hear their fate. They're among 20 activists who were charged with contempt of court, becoming law.
Who is this?
Bingo.
Building owners are responsible for managing the common parts of a building. Owners should attend meetings of owners' corporation and vote on major issues in person to safeguard their own interests. Active participation in building management benefits all.
Our city moves at a fast pace. But when there's a traffic jam, it costs us time and increases roadside air pollution. It also affects our economy and our daily life. To improve things, we must.
They sat together, closely watched by correctional services officers. Defense lawyers for Wong and the 15 other activists pointed out the mitigating factors in their clients' cases and tried to convince the court not to send them to jail. The defense noted that the case did not involve any violence nor any incitement to cause others to act violently. They then requested time to make further written submissions on the sentencing principles for young offenders and the sentencing options for contempt of court. Justice Andrew Chan delayed sentencing to a later date, accepting the defense's request to address him again.
Delete preferred networks after use. Change online password regularly. Be smart with password security.
無論在工作上遇到幾多困難，我哋都會不偏不倚，執行職務。即使查案搜證嘅過程好似大海撈針，我哋都唔會放過任何一個線索。有市民嘅支持同協助，我哋會繼續勇敢無懼，維護法紀，攜手滅罪，守護香港。
Legislative Council President Andrew Leung was forced to suspend a debate on changing the council's rules today as pro-democracy lawmakers protested inside the chamber against the move. Anne-Marie Sim reports.
The debate on changes to the rules of procedure proposed mainly by the pro-establishment camp to curb filibustering started at around 11 a.m. But the first hour of the LegCo was spent with the opposition camp making lengthy speeches and making numerous requests to the LegCo president, including asking for quorum calls and for more time to speak. Andrew Leung had earlier decided that the debate on the 49 amendments, which were submitted by both camps in the form of 12 resolutions, would be conducted in a combined debate. He also limited the speaking time for each lawmaker to 15 minutes. Can you apply some common sense to this debate? Will 15 minutes suffice? Society also thinks that if you, President, do not act in a fair manner and allow members a reasonable time to debate, would that undermine the credibility of the entire legislature? If we have separate debates and members will be able to speak at length and we will not be able to tackle all these amendments, even if we have the rest of the year. The Pan Democrat then shouted, shame on Andrew Leung for being a biased referee. If the rules of procedure are changed, the Pan Democrats will have fewer means of delaying legislating controversial anti-subversion laws under Article 23 of the Basic Law.
I think this is about conflicts of interest. I think there must be a separation between powers and personal interests. As president, there's no conflicts of interest, so I will continue to preside over the council.
My ruling shall not be debated. I'm spending time now to explain my ruling. In fact, I don't have to. Since the court disqualified six pan-democratic lawmakers, the pan-democratic camp no longer has enough votes to block proposals that make it to the voting stage. And since Article 23 legislation is a government bill, it's likely to pass with the support of the pro-establishment camp. As pro-establishment lawmaker and chairman of LegCo's Committee on Rules of Procedure, Paul Tse, tried to soldier on with reading his resolution, the opposition camp escalated its protest in the chamber. They chanted, today the rules are changed, tomorrow Article 23 will be legislated. Anne Newsom, TVB News.
Well, at around noon, the LegCo president adjourned the meeting, only to resume proceedings 5 hours later. But after just a couple of hours in the chamber, the debate was adjourned again this evening. And later this evening, PAN Democrats gathered in the center of the chamber to accuse Leung of abuse of power. Chaos ensued as the opposition ignored Leung's pleas to return to their seats. Droves of mainlanders continue to stream into Hong Kong illegally, despite efforts by local police to team up with their mainland counterparts to tackle the problem. Wen Wang with more.
Hong Kong and mainland authorities met for the fifth time in an annual meeting to discuss joint action against illegal immigrants. Guangdong, Guangxi, and Yunnan authorities stopped a total of about 67,000 illegal immigrants from Southeast Asia and South Asia, and plenty of them wanted to enter Hong Kong through the mainland, about 3,400 to be exact. Police also arrested about 1,000 smugglers, helping them cross the border. According to Yin Chenjun, the divisional chief of mainland's border control ministry, attempted illegal immigration into Hong Kong remains rampant, and the human smuggling rings have very clear and strict organization structures. Speaking this afternoon, Secretary for Security John Lee also pointed out that they are quick to adapt.
And they change their modus operandi as well. So when we try to concentrate effort at a particular point, then after they have failed a few times, then they will switch to other locations. So that change of modus operandi is a challenge.
Authorities on both sides say they will continue to tackle the problem together. Wen Wang, TVB News.
Well, a Grade 1 historic building in Tuen Mun has been spared from demolition after the current owner applied for government funds to carry out maintenance work. This old building is known as Hung Lao, which means Red House. It's said to be linked to Sun Yat-sen, the founding father of modern China. Authorities declared the building a proposed monument earlier this year to prevent it from being torn down. At today's Antiquities Advisory Board meeting, it was announced the current owner agreed to preserve the structure with financial assistance from the government. Etc. Accepting the grant means the owner cannot sell the property and must allow reasonable public access after it is completed. Overseas again, firefighters in Southern California are struggling to get the upper hand on massive fires feeding off strong, hot winds. And things are about to get worse. A rash of major blazes is being fueled by the unpredictable Santa Ana winds. The region has already been hit hard by three major fires that have put tens of thousands of people under evacuation orders and destroyed hundreds of homes and buildings. California's governor has declared a state of emergency, and officials are warning residents to expect extreme wind behavior. Firefighters are battling to save multi-million dollar homes in the path of a new fire, which forced the closure of an interstate hot freeway. The so-called Skirball fire has destroyed at least six homes and scorched a building at a winery owned by media mogul Rupert Murdoch. Researchers led by the University of Hong Kong say they've come up with a super efficient street lighting system. The team claims their LED street lights would last 15 years compared to the usual 3 years for existing systems. The system is also better for the environment. Researchers say more than 80% of the materials used to manufacture the lighting system can be recycled.
Has been launched. Key features are automatic reduction of investment risk according to MPF scheme members' age, fee caps, and globally diversified investment. If you've never given investment instructions, your trustee will send a notice to let you choose.
And cool tomorrow with an overnight low of 16 degrees. Expect the mercury to drop a little further on Saturday to 14 degrees. That is our time for the news. Thanks for joining us. Good night.